What's cracking, everybody? Welcome back to the channel. New video. Well. If this ain't a strange ass topic. First of all, shout out to this channel called JD Delay. He's got to be booming right now because his channel is popping up on my feed left and right. So I think it was around two days ago, a video pops up and it's talking about Danny Masterson, that a prison gang has put a green light on Danny Masterson. And I listened to the video, and it was the GB Jizzles. The GBGs have put a green light on Danny Masterson. And, you know, the picture was painted how... there was a picture painted. I'm not going to get into it. There's a picture painted about the GBGs, and you know, listen... Everyone behind the walls are dangerous. You don't underestimate anybody. Some are more dangerous than others. So initially we were all, well, not all. Initially, a lot of us were under the impression that Danny Masterson was going to be housed in the Corcoran SHU, PHU, Protective Housing Unit. The Protective Housing Unit, the PHU in California, is the most protected unit section. It's not even a unit. It's in a unit. It's 484 right. Unless they moved it, it's in 484 right in Corcoran SHU. And it's only one section that I'm aware of. It's only one section. And Charles Manson was there. Sirhan. That Corona guy, the Alcala guy, and I don't remember ever one time hearing that anyone housed in PHU moved on anyone else housed in PHU. Those guys are the guys that cannot go anywhere in the state, no yard, period, at all. So why would they fuck theirs off and go anywhere else, right? So when I first saw the video, I was like, how are they gonna get to him? Right. But let's just speak hypothetically. Let's say that Danny, I don't even want to call him that fucking name, eh? We got to give that fucking Hyde. We're going to call him Hyde from this point on, eh? He's or something. Somebody come up with a fucking name for that guy. That thing. But let's say he hits an SNY yard, right? I would assume that anyone on that yard, because how high profile, can't even talk talking about this fucking weirdo. He is such a high profile that I think anyone there is going to see him as a trophy as well as a gold mine. Let me emphasize that. You know, up until recently, you know, there's been a lot of murders in the CDC recently. But up until those times, keeping it real, the SNY yards were killing more people than anybody. And they were killing child molesters and rapists. They were killing sex offenders regularly on those yards. There was a study that it was done. I think it was somebody could look it up. I think it was the High Desert study or something like that. And it in the study, the report that was put out was that there are more murders and stabbings on sex offenders on SNY yards, on more murders and more stabbings, period, in the CDC on the SNY side because of the sex offenders. So it doesn't matter where Hyde goes. He's in trouble. You know, I didn't know until recently that he was tied in with Scientology and all that. And I'm not going to talk about that. I'm not going to say that they're the reason, but I guess they poured a lot of money into his defense, trying to help him out. And people are saying allegedly that Hyde was doing this foul ass stuff for decades. Decades, man. So imagine how many victims he's left behind. Whoever, because it's not, unless he goes to PHU, he's gonna get touched up. It's all bad for him. You know, I saw somewhere where it said he showed a lot of strength while he was in the Allen County jail. He was in keep away. Showed a lot of strength. Let's see how strong you are now. You know, like when I was a youngster and I thought I was the baddest motherfucker on the planet and I caught my murder and I'm fighting. I told the story. My mom's brother, fucking maniac, this dude's psychopath. He drives all the way to come to see me, tells my mom, let me see the phone, and tells me, hey, you wanted to be a tough guy, huh? Well, you're going where all the tough guys are. Let's see how tough you are now. Some shit along those lines, right? Laughed at me, handed the phone back to my mom and went back to LA. So those of you, the supporters of Hyde that made that statement that he showed a lot of strength while in the LA County jail, keep away. And let's see how strong he is now. He's entering a world, or has entered a world, that's unlike anything he's ever been around or seen. There ain't nobody that will ever have any mercy or sympathy for him, for it. I don't get people who engage in that type of shit. Period. There's so many damn women in the world. And this dude having money on top. That's that I think that's that sickness, that Hollywood sickness, right? It's a power move. It's a power play. They're just, I don't know. I don't get it. I don't think that way. Never have, never will. But back to what we're talking about. I don't know what group is going to get him. I don't even think it's going to be a group. I think it's going to be the first person that sees him. Yeah. You got to remember, when he walks in the building, there's going to be tier tenders out in whatever building he hits, unless he goes to the oil. He's going to get a celly. They're not going to single sell him. So even if he enters a building and there's nobody in the day room, when he goes into the cell, he's got a celly in there. Whoever hits that guy is going to get a lot of attention from the media, and I would think his victims. You guys, you know, it's like when that Chauvin guy, that cop got whacked, right? When there's certain people, like I remember when they did this thing and they were talking about Manson and Richard Ramirez, the Night Stalker, they were talking about how women, they say the Melendezes are the same. All these weird fucking, there's a certain type of women that think like, oh, I can help that guy. And they send money and they send packages and they send pictures of themselves and they want to marry them. And then you got dudes that are doing time for something they did when they were 17, 18, 19, 20 years old. They're 40, 42, 43, 45 years old now. Everybody fell off. Their family can't afford to send them anything anymore. They're in there hustling. They're getting by however they get by. And then here comes a weirdo like that. And I'm just speaking in general. Any, not even just S and Y. Any yard. And they see somebody like that. High notoriety. And they know. When I whack this dude, I have money on my books the rest of my life. I will have packages every quarter for the rest of my life. Because they know they're not going to get out. People out here hear that and they're like, fuck, what the fuck? That savage shit. No, that's self-preservation. Hyde did whatever he did and he's going to pay the price. That's one thing. You know, when that's one of the reasons why I've always been against the death penalty. Prison, the society... Prison society has its own rules and regulations. Sending people to death row saves a lot of people, or certain people, because they're going to die on death row from old age in California. Now I think they shut it down again. And so the guys that were housed on death row and knew they were going to grow old, and you know, death row, for those of you that don't know, when you go to prison in California, once you get out of orientation and you hit a yard, your status is called A2B. A2B means they just, basically it's, you don't have a job, you're not in education, so you can only come out at certain times, and you know, then you have A1A, those are the workers. When you go, when you're A2B, I think the max you can go to store, unless they've changed things now, it's 110 a month, right? If you're A1A, you can go 220. If you're A2B, you'll get one phone call a month. That's the way it used to be. Now they have tablets and shit so they can do. But we're just going to go by the old way, right? They will get one phone call a month. A1A, A2B, one phone call a month. A1A, they can get one every day as long as there's a sign up. You know, they can make it to their cell. Well, dudes that went to death row, because there's no jobs and there's no education, you know, like you don't get a job assignment or an education assignment, they were automatically A1A status. They were automatically able to spend 220, get on the phone whenever, you know, the phone over there comes to the cell on wheels. Yeah, that's all out the window. If they shut down death row, no, you got it. Now they got to go to a yard. They're no longer protected, you know. I hope Danny Masterson doesn't go to PHU. I don't wish nothing bad on anybody, but I want justice for the victims. Let's say it like that. Justice for the victims. Nobody do anything bad to anybody. But see, in prison, it doesn't work that way. Societal laws, the ones out here, society's rules. Man, those guys, I was a crook. I didn't give a fuck about the laws in society, this society out here. I lived by my own. And that's why when they busted me, I knew it. I'm never getting out. I'm going to die in there. Luckily, some laws were passed. Some bills were passed. And, you know, thousands and thousands of lifers were able to get out and we're doing great out here. But anyways, I'm getting sidetracked. If it's true that Danny Masterson is not in PHU, it don't matter what group. I don't know what. I've never heard of anything like what's being said. But I can guarantee that there are some people that their stomach's empty right now. Or they're tired of asking somebody, can they borrow something? Excuse me. When Danny Masterson is coming into one of their buildings. I don't know what building. I don't know where he's going. I know one thing. The CDC has to be stressed out. The administration, the brass, Sacramento has to be stressed out about this one individual. But hey, house him. It's all you guys got to do. Your job is to house him. Stop stressing. Let him do it. All right, man, that's my video for today. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Everybody, please be safe, be smart, and tell the ones you love that you love them. I'm out.